St. Kitts and Nevis Supervisor of Election, Elvin Bailey, has been accused by the St. Kitts and Nevis Labour Party, SKNLP, of deception following a video statement made by Bailey in response to earlier SKNLP accusations of unfair procedures carried out by the electoral office. In the video, which has been removed from YouTube by the user, Mr. Bailey explained several of the procedures that the electoral office carries out, but did not indicate if the office had breached any. In short, the SKNLP is accusing Bailey of not telling the truth about some of the procedures being carried out by the electoral office. The SKNLP has accused Bailey and the electoral office of systematically removing the registered names of Labour Party supporters without following the procedures outlined under the National Assembly Elections Act and in keeping with the Constitution of St. Kitts and Nevis. The SKNLP media release says, quote, "The statement issued by Mr. Bailey has only served to further clarify what the St. Kitts and Nevis Labour Party has been saying about the supervisor of elections for some time, that Mr. Bailey has been appointed to assist the parties in government in subverting democracy and disenfranchising opposition supporters," end quote. According to the statement, objections from the SKNLP regarding some registered voters were denied a hearing, while the objections made by other political parties were heard and used to remove Labour Party supporters from the list of registered voters. The SKNLP also accused the electoral office and the supervisor of elections of not giving appropriate notice to registered voters whose names were being objected to. On this, the SKNLP statement responds, quote, "Turns out that almost 0% of persons objected to made an appearance at the objection hearing. This is because not many persons who were objected to actually received notice of an objection to their registration. We are requesting Ms. Bailey to provide the data on that," end quote. According to the SKNLP statement, the alleged offenses are outrageous, appalling, and are at odds with the tenets of good governance and democracy. Glenn Barth for SKN Newsline.